In this video, I'm going to record an in-situ dataset while controlling a DENSsolutions wildfire heating holder within GMS. I'll begin by starting a live view with the K3IS camera. Here we're looking at a tin nanoparticle sample, and now I'll turn on lookback and set the buffer to keep 5 seconds of data. Now, I'm going to start the live FFT as well so that we can see what's happening to the sample. Right now, the tin is melted at 250 degrees C, so I don't expect to see any lattice fringes, and I'll just change the FFT to a nice vivid color scale. Now, I'll start the temperature ramp. I'm ramping down to 50 degrees over 100 seconds. And I've sped up the video playback here as nothing really interesting is happening. But right when the tin crystallizes, I'm going to hit record. And because we have a lookback buffer of 5 seconds, even though I pressed record after the crystallization happened, we'll still capture that moment of crystallization in the dataset. There. Now I'm seeing a spot in the FFT, so I've pressed record, and because I have lookback set to 5 seconds, my video will start before that FFT spot appeared. And again, I'll speed up the playback of my screen capture here, as this part is a bit tedious to watch. Now my temperature ramp has stopped, but I will give the sample a bit of time to reach equilibrium and stop moving before I stop my in-situ video acquisition. The software will finish recording the last bit of data. I'll just stop the live view since I don't need that anymore, and I'll open up the in-situ dataset that I just collected. The software takes me straight to the right location, and so now I can play back my data. I'll set the zoom level of the display to be a simple fraction, and turn on the live FFT as well. Now I'll collapse and expand different palettes so that I have the in-situ player and editor visible in my technique pane. And I can play back my dataset now at real speed, or I can speed it up a bit if I want to. And right there, I can see a distinct onset of that spot in the FFT when the tin crystallizes.